Students, good morning. Welcome to online learning standard 12 subject chemistry. Dear students, in 12th standard chemistry we have been discussing the unit number 6, which is solid state. And in the solid state lesson, using the previous video, we have seen what are called as primitive and non-primitive unit cells, isn't it? Also the types of unit cells, those are the things we have completed using the previous video. And today in this video we are going to learn how we are going to calculate the number of atoms per unit cell. Students, we have a number of unit cells. The most common unit cells are, and shall we remember what are called as unit cells? We know that unit cells are the building blocks of a crystal lattice, isn't it? Yes. Now we are going to calculate the number of atoms present per unit cell of the different crystal systems. Okay, ma? Okay, ma. Look here. First, we are going to calculate the number of atoms for the simple cubic system. You know about simple cubic system. What are called as simple cubic system? In the case of simple cubic system, the constituent particles, which may be an atom, an ion, or a molecule, the constituent particle occupy only the corner position, isn't it? Yes, such kind of unit cell is called as simple cubic unit cell. Okay, look here. In the case of simple cubic unit cell, each atom of the cubic system contributes 1/8 of its original volume. Look here, ma. This is the picture of simple cubic system. Here the atoms occupy only at the 8 corners of the cube, and so this structure is called as simple cubic system. Now each atom, look here, if we take this atom present at the corner, out of its total volume, it may have a particular volume, but out of its total volume it can contribute only 1/8 part of its total volume. How much it is contributing? It is contributing 1/8 of its total volume. And so each atom at the corner contributes how much? They can contribute 1/8 of their original volume. This we have to remember. Always the atoms at the corner, they can contribute only 1/8 of their total volume. Okay, that is given here. Each atom of the simple cubic system contributes 1/8 of its original volume for the construction of simple cubic unit cell. So dear students, tell me, what is the contribution of each atom in a simple cubic unit cell? They can contribute only 1/8 portion. Okay, va? Okay, now let us see the calculation. Look here, total number of atoms per simple cubic unit cell, which is equal to the number of atoms at the corners. How many corners we have for a cubic system? Totally we have 8 corners. So this total number of atoms at the corner will be 8 into 1/8. Why it is 1/8? Because each atom contributes 1/8 of its original volume, and so this total number of atoms is multiplied by 1/8, so which is equal to 8 into 1/8, that is equal to 1. Okay, ma. So the number of atoms present per unit cell of a simple cubic system is 1. Is it clear, students? Yes. Now let us see the second type of cubic system, which is body-centered cubic cell. You know about body-centered cubic cell. What is body-centered cubic cell? In a simple cubic unit cell, in addition to the corner position, the center of the unit cell will be occupied by an atom, and so the structure will be called as body-centered cubic system. See, this is the structure of body-centered cubic system. Here we have atoms at the corners. At all the 8 corners we have the atoms. In addition, at the center of this cube we have an additional atom, and so the crystal structure, which is body-centered cubic system, is generated. Okay, so this is the crystal structure of body-centered cubic system. Now we are going to calculate the number of atoms per unit cell of a body-centered cubic system. Okay. Now we have to calculate the contribution of the atoms present at the corners and at the body center as well. Is it clear, students? In the previous case, we have calculated only the contribution of atoms present at the corners. But in the case of body-centered cubic unit cell, we have to consider the contribution of both the atoms present at the corners as well as at the body center. Okay, well, students? Okay, remember the contribution of the corner atoms will be the same as in the case of simple cubic system. Now, look at the body-centered atom. It contributes its entire volume for the construction of this body-centered cubic unit cell. So, it is given that each atom at the corner contributes 1/8 of its original volume. In addition, the atom at the body center contributes its whole volume. Okay, so this is the case of body-centered cubic system. Once again, let me read. Each atom at the corner, which is the corner atom, they can contribute how much? They can contribute 1/8 of their original volume. Whereas the body-centered atom, it can contribute its entire volume. Okay, okay. Now let us calculate the number of atoms of body-centered cubic unit cell. It is given here. Number of atoms per unit cell, which is equal to, we have to add two different terms. The first term is total number of atoms at the corners. How many corners we have? 8. So 8 into 1/8 plus number of atoms at the body center. How many body center we have for a cubic system? Only one body center is there. So 1 into 1. Okay, which is equal to 8 into 1/8 plus 1 into 1, that is equal to 2. Okay, so what is the number of atoms per unit cell of body-centered cubic system? It is 2. In the case of simple cubic system, the number of atoms per unit cell is 1. Whereas in the case of body-centered cubic system, the number of atoms per unit cell is 2. Okay, okay. Now, the type number 3, which is face-centered unit cell. In the case of face-centered unit cells, students, we know that face-centered in the sense, how many faces does a cubic system possess? It has 6 faces. So, at the center of each face of a cube, there will be an atom. And so, the crystal structure is known as face-centered cubic system. Okay, so, here in the case of face-centered cubic system, the atoms are present in two positions. Position number 1 is corners, the constituent particle, that is the atom present at all the corners. In addition, there will be some atoms at the center of each face of the cube. Okay, this type is called as face-centered unit cell. Look here. Now, let us see the contribution. Before that, we want to see the structure of face-centered cubic system. This is the face-centered cubic system. Here, the yellow color points, these are the atoms present at the corners, whereas the pink colored atoms, look here, faces, at the center of each faces there is an atom, and so this type of unit cell is called as face-centered cubic unit cell. Okay, dear students, in this case also we have to calculate the contribution of the atoms present at different positions. Okay, here again we can remember the contribution of an atom at the corner will be the same as in the case of a simple cubic system as well as in the case of body-centered cubic system. In the case of a simple cubic system, we have seen that the atom present at the corner can contribute how much? It can contribute 1/8 of its total volume. That we are familiar, isn't it? Yes, the same thing will be observed in the case of face-centered cubic system also. Okay, the atoms at the corner of this face-centered system, they can contribute 1/8 of their original volume. Then how many corners we have? We have 8 corners. So we can write 8 into 1/8. Then we have to see about the contribution of atom present at the face center. Okay, well, dear students, an atom present at the center of a face, it can contribute 1/2 of its total volume. Okay, how much it is contributing? It can contribute 1/2 of its original volume. So it's given here, each atom at the corner contributes 1/8 of its original volume. In addition, the atom at the face center can contribute 1/2 of its whole volume or original volume. Okay, by using this knowledge we can calculate the number of atoms present in a face centered cubic unit cell that I have shown here. The number of atoms per unit cell, which is equal to total number of atoms at the corners into 1/8 plus number of atoms at the face center into 1/2. Why do we write here 1/2? Because we know that an atom at the face center can contribute half of its original volume, and so it is written that into 1/2. So this term is equal to 8 into 1/8. This 8 is the number of corners. How many corners we have? 8 corners. So 8 into 1/8 plus 6. This 6 in the sense number of atoms at the face centers. We have how many faces for a cube? We have 6 faces for a cube. So there are 6 atoms present at the center of face. So 6 into 1/2, which is equal to 3. And so we can write 1 plus 3, that is equal to 4. Okay, my dear students. So in the case of face centered cubic system, the number of atoms per unit cell is 4. Okay, so what are the things we have seen so far? We have calculated the number of atoms per unit cell. In the case of simple cubic system, the atoms present only at the corners, and here the total number of atoms per unit cell is 1. Then secondly, in the case of body-centered cubic system, the atoms are present both at the corners as well as the center of the cube, and here the total number of atoms is 2. Then finally, in the case of face-centered cubic system, we have the atoms at the corners as well as the center of each face, and here the total number of atoms per unit cell is 4. Okay, Vama? Okay, with this video ends. It's very, very important concept. We have to be very familiar. Okay, dear students, you can watch the video twice to have a clear and better understanding. Thank you.